Should we get to close the board?
Yeah, wallahi, inshallah. Abdul Aziz, Muhammad, can you hear? Allah yahfaz. Yeah. Now, you turn from the other room. Yeah, from here is good. No, push it back. طيب، على بركة الله إن شاء الله نبدأ شرح الشبراوية. شرح الشبراوية. And let's see. I think it's the last. No, it's in the middle of the book that we have now. So here. Part that you don't have in the book, I will read it from the sharh I have here. بعد بسم الله والصلاة والسلام على رسول الله وعلى آله وصحبه ومن والاه. قال يقول الفقير عبد الله الشبراوي الشافعي قد سألني من يعز علي أن أنظم له أبيات تشتمل على قواعد فن العربية فأجبته لما سأل طالبا من الله بلوغ الأمل ورتبته على خمسة أبواب. طيب. Here, as I said, you know, this is going to be our manhaj. I read the text in Arabic, I translate it, and we do the sharh. يقول الفقير. الفقير. The poor to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So first he start with Bismillah ar-Rahman ar-Rahim, and this is, as you know, following all the books and the letters that the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam used to send, starting with the name of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Al-faqiru, he's yaqulu al-faqiru is the poor Abdullah al-Shubrawi Shafi. So his name Abdullah Al-Shubrawi. Al-Shubrawi is like reference to a town in Egypt, Shubra, فهو شبراوي. Al-Shafi'i, following the Shafi'i madhab, so he is one of the scholar of fuqaha of Al-Shafi'i. Al-Faqiru, he is the poor. The poor is, subhanallah, the quality of humility to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. As Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala qala antumul fuqara'u ila Allah. You are the poor to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. When someone say, I'm a servant of Allah, is like being pleased and honored to be. And al-faqiru in a way of showing humility to Allah and modesty. And modesty. So instead of saying, you know, the great scholar, the great knowledgeable person, the most famous, you know, I'm saying, there's no such a thing. So you say, the poor to Allah, Abdullah al-Shubrawi says. Very simple. قَدْ سَأَلَنِي مَنْ يَعِزُّ عَلَيَّ قَدْ سَأَلَنِي مَنْ يَعِزُّ عَلَيَّ يَعِزُّ عَزَّ comes, it has different meaning. From al-Aziz, the powerful, the might. عَزَّ الشَّيْءُ becomes like something like عَزَّ, it becomes rare. هُنَا يَعِزُّ from someone that I respect, someone that is dear to me. from Aziz. Azizun alayya is me like dear to me. Someone or azaztu or azaztu, akramtu. Also Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala qala azzaza, azzaza bithalithin, like strengthen, zada, you make them stronger. But here ya'izzu alayya, someone who's dear to me. And anzima lahu abiyatan, compile and made the poem abiyatan. And al-baytu is the verse, al-baytu is the verse. Tashtamilu, you know, verses or poem will be with the topic that it contain the main basis and rules of the Arabic language. The basis and the rules of the Arabic language. فَأَجَبْتُهُ لِمَا سَأَلْ فَأَجَبْتُ, I answer him to you, I fulfilled his request. أَجَبْتُهُ لِمَا سَأَلْ, so here, سَأَلَ, he asked, it's either I promised him or I did. So, أَجَبْتُهُ لِمَا سَأَلْ, and here he will be asking Allah to give the tawfiq to fulfill the request of the one who asked him to do to write a book, such a book, helping the student of knowledge to review and to learn the qawa'id of the Arabic language, the principle and the rules of the Arabic language. طالباً من الله بلوغ الأمل, invoking Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to achieve this request, بلوغ الأمل. ورتبته على خمسة أبواب ورتبته, so this book, this poem, I divided in five topics or five chapters, five parts. الباب الأول, the first part, the first chapter, if you can say it, the first part, في الكلام عند النحات, في الكلام عند النحات, the meaning of speech according to the nuhat. And nuhat, we mentioned what it means, nahu, and those who are, you know, writing and author into the language, and mainly here we're talking the grammar and the rules of the Arabic language, they call them al-nuhat. What the meaning, what is the meaning of speech, of words, of speaking according to al-nuhat. الباب الثاني في الإعراب اصطلاحا. الباب الثاني is an al-i'rab. And you're going to go through this, the meaning of the إعراب. الثالث في مرفوعات الأسماء. في مرفوعات. الأسماء are the names. الأسماء are the names. And then اسم مرفوع. اسم مرفوع is a quality of the name in a specific position in the sentence or in the speech. So we're going to see, insha'Allah ta'ala, what are the signs of the or how a name can be marfu, and we're going to explain the meaning of marfu. Okay, marfu, you're going to explain the meaning of it. Qala fi mansubat al-asma'i, and then when the names are in state of mansuba, we're going to explain the meaning of mansuba. And the fifth one, fi makhfudat al-asma', makhfudat. When is makhfuda? Usually we call maksura, but al-khafdu is a'ammu min al-kasri. فَقُلْتُ وَعَلَى اللَّهِ تَوَكَّلْتُ, I'm saying, and I'm relying and trusting in Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So this is his brief introduction before we starting the first verse. الباب الأول في الكلام وما يتألف منه. الباب الأول, he said, I'm going to في الكلام, or he said في الكلام وما يتألف منه. So this is the you have it in the first page or the second page of the book. I mean of the part where it has the نحو. You have here starting. If you want to follow الباب الأول here. الباب الأول. الباب الأول في الكلام وما يتألف منه. طيب. كلام is the speech. كلام. From تكلم. Where's my? So وزي قال في الكلام. Let's write the word كلام for you. Inshallah, all of you read the Quran. So he قال الكلام. الكلام. Just here. الكلام. طيب الكلام. Just have this word. When we say speech words, you know what you say. This is the كلام. تكلم. He's speaking. تكلم. He's speaking. What is the definition of كلام? What is the definition of كلام according to the نحويين? قال, it is the word that has a meaning that we call it كلام. A word from the Arabic language has a meaning. When we say al-lafzu is the word. So kalam, al-kalam comes into lafz. Al-lafzu is like to utter, to say, to express. So al-lafzu huwa as-sawtu al-mushtamilu ala ba'd al-hurufi. So it is a sawt. A voice containing some letters. So what is a lafzu? Is voice containing letters. Because you can voice, does not have letters. You just say, hey. But a sawtu containing letters. Structures according the Arabic language. So murakkaba ala al-arabiyya. For example, if you say, this is a voice containing letter, but you know, structured in the English language. When it's structured in the Arabic language, we call it lafz. Lafz. Therefore, when you say lafz and sawt, a voice containing letters, we are excluding here, because we said what is kalam, we said is lafz. So we are excluding signs, speaking with the signs, it's not from here. So nahwiyin, they don't gonna make i'rab of the signs. Wadh. قال فخرج عليهم من المحراب فأوحى إليهم أن سبحوا بكرة وأشياء. He didn't speak. He said with signs, سبحوا بكرة وأشياء. So that's not كلام. That's not كلام. وأوحى ربك إلى النحل. He inspired to Allah سبحانه وتعالى to the bees. It wasn't كلام. So we exclude when we say اللفظ any ishara, any signs, any communication other than, you know, without voices. قال لفظ الموضوع وضعا عربيا, structured according to the Arabic language. لمعنى مفرد. So it has a meaning. It has a meaning. A voice containing a letter but express a meaning. That is al-kalam. That is what is al-kalam. For example, قال المعنى. So we exclude any words does not have meaning is not called kalam. For example, say Zayd. Said Zayd. Abd al-Aziz. Is this kalam Arabi? I said yes, kalam Arabi. Let's implement the definition. Abdul Aziz, you heard, so it's a voice. It has letters عين با دال ألف لام عين زاي إلى آخره. It does have meaning. Yes, the meaning is this is a name. When I say Zayd, it's a name. If I inverse Zayd, I'm going to say days. This is not kalam. Why? Because muhmal, muhmal does not have meaning. Okay? So, اللفظُ الموضوع وضعًا عربيًا لمعنى مفرد. That's the kalam. According to the Nahwiyin. طيب. More also, they add another characteristic to the kalam. He said, it is a kalam that قال هنا when you stop, you fulfill a meaning. Because there's a way of stop. For example, when you read a sentence, when you stop on a dot. For example, so say, Zaydun. He said, what happened to Zayd? What Zayd? But we said, Zayd. This is kalamun. When you stepped on it, you expressed the full meaning. You said the name. But when you say it without the intention of the stopping, there's no full meaning. So this is, according to the Nahwiyin, is not kalam. Because you're not expressing a full meaning. طيب. قال المركب. عندنا we have عند النحويين. This is what we have mentioned is the definition of كلمة. Because we have كلام, the plural of كلمة. كلمة, كلام. كلمة. And the plural of it, this is the plural of كلمة. جمع. So the كلمة is what we have. كلام is the plural of كلمة. So you're going to combine more than one word, but more than one word, they need also to express a meaning. For example, I say زيدٌ قائمٌ. What it means, قائمٌ? Standing. زيدٌ is standing. زيدٌ قائمٌ. So we have two words together. They express a meaning, which is mean Zayd is standing. So that's the definition of kalima and definition of kalam. Definition of kalima, what definition of kalam. Now here there's faida, faida jamila. قال يحسن السكوت عليها. فمثلا إن قام زيد ليس بكلام عند النحويين. لأنه لا يفيد فائدة يحسن السكوت عليها. If the sentence, the sentence, when someone express it, it does not really reflect the full meaning. For he said, in case Zayd stand, in قام زيد. According to the نحويين, this one does not have meaning, so it does not كلام, because you didn't help me to understand what you want. In Zaydun Qa'im. Qa'im. In Zaydun Qa'im. Okay. There's another one which is also nice to know. Qala al-kalam also, whatever words according to the scholar, to the fuqaha, they call it kalam. Why? Because the objective is different. The objective of defining the words is different. For the example, the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, he said, speaking in the salah, void the salah. Okay? Does speaking in the salah here require words that make a sense and express a meaning, or any type of words will invalidate the salah? Any type of words? Why? Because here is the noise, is the non-dhikr that is required the salah that you do. So any noise, according to the hadith, is called kalam. But for us, we want the kalam that has expressive meaning. Why? Because we are in the topic of nahw. We are in the topic of the nahw. Rather, type. So this is the difference, the meaning of kalima and the meaning of the kalam. So the kalam, kalima is the voice containing letters that it has a meaning on its own. Al-kalam is every lafad that it has meaning on its own. When I combine and express a full meaning, he said Zayd. Zayd is a person. Another word, qa'imun, adjective, is state what he's doing. Qa'imun, so Zaydun is standing. So this is for the Nahween, is a full kalam. Full kalam. Wada? It's kalam because in case Zayd stand, I said, finish me the meaning. This is composed with kalima, but the whole sentence, it does not express a meaning for it, is not kalam. Because the nahu, its objective is to communicate a message, to communicate a full meaning. Okay, so he said, in qama zaydun, طيب, in case Zayd stand, what do you want me to do? Say, if Zayd stand, I will leave. This is becomes kalam, because it has, so I said, okay, Zayd, please, don't stand. If not, he's going to leave. So there is a communication, there is a message. But he said, in qama Zaydun, I said, what is going to happen if Zayd stand? So it's not kalam, so there's no full meaning. That's the nahwi. The first verse, we start inshallah with the first verse, and then we go pray and come back. Ya talib al-nahwi khud minni qawa'idah manzumatan jumlatan min ahsanil jumal. O seeker of the nahw, take from me the rules of it, compiled and put together in a poem and in a concise way and a beautiful way. That's what he's saying. So he's encouraging you. This is the first verse. So you go to the page in the middle of, so the first page. So في الكلام وما يتألف منه, that what we were talking here. Now the first verse, يا طالب النحو خذ مني قواعدة منظومة جملة من أحسن الجمل منظومة جملة من أحسن الجمل. واضح. Second one, so this is easy, you know. All the seeker or seeking to learn the nahw, take from me what I have compiled into a poem, easy and concise and beautiful. Second one, في ضمن خمسين بيتا لا تزيد سوى بيت به قد سألت العفو عن زللي. In almost in 50 verses, bait. قال في خمسين بيتا لا تزيد, not more, except one verse I added to praise Allah in it. سوى بيت في ضمني, in almost 50 بيت verse. لا تزيد, not more than 50, except بيت, one verse, به, in this verse I invoke Allah forgiveness for my mistakes. And we stop at the forgiveness to go pray. Tayyip. Do you want to take the break now? And then we come back, finish the half an hour of we have many prayers, mashallah, alhamdulillah. Let's pray and come back. What do you think? Prayer and come back. So we pray and we come back right away, okay? And then, inshallah, we take short break because we have, mashallah, prayer. And then for you, if anyone who want to do a break of, you know, snack or something, then we do the tajweed and we go pray and come back, finish the tajweed. Because the Isha, I think, is at 8:15. Eh? Khair, inshallah. Ala barakatullah. Let's go pray and come back. And then we take the break. بسم الله والصلاة والسلام على رسول الله وعلى آله وصحبه ومن والاه أما بعد. We'll continue إن شاء الله تعالى after the صلاة. We resume with the second verse that we already have read, but that's from where we're going to be resuming. يقول المصنف في ضمن خمسين بيتا لا تزيد سوى بيت به قد سألت العفو عن زللي. In within or 50 verse, not more than that, except one verse in which I invoke Allah for His forgiveness from my own zalal, mistakes and shortcoming. إن أنت أتقنتها هانت مسائله عليك من غير تطويل ولا ملل. إن أنت أتقنتها, إن أنت, if you student of knowledge, we learn it, you know, precisely, and you learn it in a good way. أتقنتها, it means like you learn it quite good, if you can say. الإتقان is someone to perfect the understanding of it, or to be good in understanding. هانت مسائله, so all the مسائل, all the issues, and all what is required to be learned and understand will be easy for you then, talking about the Arabic language. عليك من غير تطويل, and I did it without making it long. ولا ملل, ملل make you to get bored and tired. Number four. أما الكلام اصطلاحا فهو عندهم مركب فيه إسناد كقام علي. Now we're getting into the heart of the action, if you can say. قال أما الكلام, number four. أما الكلام, now we're talking about the speech. اصطلاحا, اصطلاحا, الاصطلاح, الاصطلاح, which is mean the definition of a term, knowing within the that expert of that art or expert of that discipline. So istilahan, so amma al-kalam, we already mentioned that before already. Amma al-kalam, when it comes to the speech as a terminology in among the nahwiyin, fahwa indahum, it is defined by مركبون. مركبون structured. تركيب is to structure one word with another word. Put, gather, مركب. فيه إسنادون. إسنادون is like to put one word with another one. Huh? Not here the إسناد, nothing have to do with the terminology of the hadith. We're talking about the Arabic. إسنادون. كقام علي, I'll give you an إسناد. So a meaning, a sentence, two words together to give a meaning. Ka qama ali. So this is a speech and qama ali. Qama ali. Qama ali. And we stop on the sukun. Qama ali. Ka qama ali. قال يعني أن الكلام في اصطلاح النحاة ما كان مركبا وفيه إسناد. It is gathered, put together, and it has إسناد. قوله مركب, what it mean مركب؟ أي من كلمتين فأكثر. So the speech here require at least two words or more. Two words or more. So here cannot by one single word. لفظ or مهملة, مهملة does not have meaning in its own, as when we say a name زيد, it has meaning. قولي فيه إسناد يعني شرط الكلام أن يكون مسندا. والمركب الإسنادي نوعان. So المركب الإسنادي نوعان. Is either you have two names or you have a verb and a name. For example, two names, مركب إسنادي, زيد قائم, زيد قائم, قائم, زيد قائم, قام علي, this is قام, verb, and this is علي, subject, which is noun, and this is زيد, noun, قائم, noun, اسم, we call it اسم, اسم, اسم. This one we call it فعل, verb is name, فعل, فعل. We have to memorize this, because it's going to be easy. This is all like very general, inshallah, we're going to be easy. So when we have a sentence, yes. Yeah, when we have musnad, like together two words to express a meaning, a sentence. So we have al-murakkab al-isnadi, is either you're going to use names to express a whole meaning or to use a verb and a name.
What about the adjective?
Well, verb and a name, the name, it's not, the name can be subject or adjective. You know, so that's what we call عامل. العامل is what the action that affect the whole state we are describing. So name and a verb, because we're going to come to know all the kalam is divided in three categories. Names, verbs, and letters, حروف. That all the language fall under three categories. Verb, names, and حروف. الحرف is in itself does not have a meaning. To, for, إلى, على, تحت. Say تحت, under. You're going to say under what? If I say Zaydun, it's a name. You know, Zayd is a name of a person. If I said Qama, so a verb. But the way I say verb, we're going to study all this. The verb, it has the effect of time. The name is not related. It has a meaning, but it does not have the effect of time. I said Aliyun. Does the time have to do anything with it? قام, stand, علي, stood. I didn't stand. If I say قائم, I know that he's standing now. Or it might, you know, another name, قائم, it might mean a metaphor. قائم بذاته, he's like, he's strong, he's standing, you know. But the verb always associated with the time. So قام علي, this is mean قام, where? In the past. علي يقوم, in the future. So we're going to study this. You know, this is, the book is about this. To understand the Arabic language and its basis and how every, you know, from these categories, how they're going to behave into a sentence. That's what the behavior is going to be, adjective or subject. You know, that's the behavior, how it's going to be in the sentence. So, قال, so, كقام علي استغنى بالمثال على عن أن يقول مفيد فائدة يحسن السكوت عليه. So when he gave us the example, قام علي, قال example, قام علي. So we say قام علي, علي stood. So when he said these two words, he gave you full meaning of this description that he wants to communicate to you. Okay? قام علي. So which is mean, any words you combine together, that it is, when you step in it, you fulfill a whole meaning, and you express a whole meaning, that is the language, that is the speech in the Arabic language according to the Nahwi. Okay? So if you say قام علي, so like لفظ voice, it has contains letters expressed in two words, distant words, it and expressing and fulfilling and communicating a whole meaning. That's the كلام. What? Number five. قال والاسم والفعل ثم الحرف جملتها أجزاؤه فهو عنها غير منتقل. This is what I said. قال والاسم والفعل ثم الحرف قوله أجزاؤه أي أجزاء الكلام. So the parts or the categories of the speech are what we have mentioned. اسم فعل حرف. The whole كلام comes in three categories. One, two, three. اسم فعل حرف. اسم, that we say, الاسم والفعل ثم الحرف. اسم is the noun, فعل is a verb, حرف is the letter, but the letter is not like one letter, but to combine between the اسم and the فعل to show something like toward, under, above. So these are in the Arabic language, call them حرف. That's why the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم قال لا أقول ألف لام ميم حرف. To specify that the harf in the Arabic language can have like two letters, three letters, five letters. So he specified, he said, I don't say alif, lam, mim, harf, but I say alif, harf, lam, harf. So he specified, you're talking about the single letters, not the letters that it comes combined in few letters together. So harf in the Arabic language is not translated into specifically one letter, but is in combination of letter who do not express a full meaning when you say it on its own. طيب. قال هنا قال يعني أن أجزاء الكلام ثلاثة. اسم وفعل وحرف. So the categories of the speech in the Arabic language, اسم فعل حرف. اسم فعل حرف. Noun, verb, and letter. And the حرف, as I said. What is this, the evidence of that? The evidence is the study and, you know, following the pattern and the al-istiqra, what has been, you know, studied, analyzed, presented in the among the scholar of the Arabic and the scholars of the of al-Nahwiyin, etc., that all the speech comes under the three categories. There's no more any other category. That's why قال فهو عنها غير منتقل. From this category you don't find anything else. So you see, he make it easy for you. He make it easy for you. All the Arabic language fall under three categories. اسم وفعل وحرف. Very easy, inshallah. He started with the ism. He started with the name. Because the name is the most important category in the language. There is no sentence, or there is no expression or communication does not have name. And al-murakkab al-isnadi, the two examples, either comes with two names or a name and a verb. In the both of them, there's a name. In the both structure, in the both combination of words, there's a name. So he started the name because he's the most honored in the structure. There's always a name. قال وبدأ بالاسم لشرفه إذ لا يتخلى الكلام عنه أبدا فالمركب الإسنادي لا يكون إلا من اسمين أو اسم وفعل as we may have mentioned. This in the second category we have الفعل. الفعل is the verb. Because he's in a lower grade than the name. ثم الحرف, then the letter, حرف, let's call it حرف. I don't want to call it letter because we can be confused. So his name حرف. الحرف is a combination of letters that, you know, when you say it on its own, does not express the meaning. قال وعطفه بثم, look, he said, الاسم والفعل then al-harf, then al-harf. To show you that he's in the lowest of the grade compared to the name, nouns, and then the fi'l. Al-ism wal-fi'l wal-harf has their own definition in the language, and they have their special definition in according to the scholar of Nahu. In the language, al-ismu ma dalla ala musamma. What is al-ism? Ma dalla ala musamma. The name in the language, what instruct or give you the name of a thing, that's the name. That's anything that you give it a name, that's what we call a name. ما دل على مسمى, something being named, you know, كأس name, كراس, كتاب, etc. More specification when we come to the نحو. So I give you the definition, not any name. He said, كلمة دلت على معنى في نفسها. It's a word that has a meaning in itself, not associated with time. Why we want this specification? So we know the difference between the name and the verb. Like say, Ali is a word. Its meaning is a name of a person called Ali. Not associated with time, because you say Ali, it does not have any effect of time. Can I say Ali? You said, oh, you meant Ali in the present or in future. You said, does nothing have, it does not make any sense what you say. So, كَلِمَةٌ دَلَّتْ فِي نَفْسِهَا مَعْنَى. So, when you say it, it has meaning in own self. Not associated, not affected by time. So that's the name. طيب. الفعل, الفعل, الفعل. In the language, what is the meaning of الفعل? هو الحدث. الحدث, a happening. something happened, a happening. That's the fi'l. It said someone sitting, qala qama, hadath, something happened, I stood, hadath. When I say, for example, Ali, there's no zaman, there's no something happening. As you are describing Ali, kas, kas, kurras, notebook. فالفعل في اللغة معناه حدث حدث. Now give more specification. We're gonna give more specification when we take it to the definition according to النحوي, according to the scholar of نحو. ماذا يقولون لك؟ كلمة دلت على معنى في نفسها واقترنت بأحد الأزمنة الثلاث. It's a word when you say it. It communicates, it has a meaning its own self when you say it. But associated with one of the tense, one of the three tenses. What are the three tenses? Past, present, and future. So when he said qama, sama, sama min sawmin, sama fast, from fasting. But when I say sama, sama, what is the tense associated to my saying sama? It's the past. Say sama, past. So sawmun sama, when I say sama, it's enough for you to understand the meaning of sama. But I add another information to you, which is the tense that is associated with it. So I said, قال عليٌ صام. Say okay. So then he said, then he gonna come to with us tomorrow to dinner, to lunch. He said, no, I told you عليٌ صام. I said, okay, I understand. صام, he fast in the past. Told me, no, I meant that he cannot come tomorrow with us because he's gonna be fasting. Say no, say عليٌ سيصوم. He's going to fast tomorrow. Then I understand. So when he told me Sama, I know what it means, Sama, fast. But by saying Sama, he associated with the tense, which is the past. So if you're gonna planning for tomorrow for a lunch, you know, I'll be sure that he can come because his commitment of fasting has been already done. But the person, he wants to tell me, you know, we should not make include him in a plan because he's going to be fasting tomorrow. So I said, you give me the wrong communication. واضح. So, الفعل حدث, a happening. حدث. يفيد معنى في نفسه. When you say it, you understand the meaning. There's a meaning that fully understood. Add to it that is connected, associated to one of the tenses. Well, this is al-fi'l.
What is fast?
Fast, look, in the Arabic, fast, for example.
Yeah.
Someone is say, he's fasting, right?
He's fasting, that
is... But fast is the verb.
Yeah.
Too fast. Okay. Too, you said too fast. نحن نقول فعل صام. So I said, Sama is that like fi'l. But Sama in itself, Sama, if I say Sama, Sama, it means that he fasted in the past. Sama Aliyun, Aliyun fast in the past. Well, is associated with the tense. That's the fi'l. And the three tense, قال ماض ومضارع وأمر والأمر هو الحاضر لأنه المضارع in Arabic المضارع which is the future has present and future in the same time which is it's funny because some of the philosophers they deny the existence of present, which is, goes more with the Arabic spirit, you know, because whatever you're going to say, I'm going to do it, it becomes a future right away. So we have al-mudara is the action we extend from now to the future. That's the mudara. So I say, qa'imun aqumu is mean like, I'm going to do it right now. You know, as soon as I do it, I said qama, stood. Okay? So I say, I'm going to stand. I'm standing. In the Arabic, you put it together. But if I want to put it, push it to the future, say I add sa'aqumu, I'm going to. We'll study it, inshallah. For, so we have three tenses. What are these three tenses? No, that's the verb, the tense, the time. No, past, look, madin, past, mudara, connected, present and future, amrun, command, imperative form, do. For example, sama, past, yasumu, mudara, amr, sum, fast, said, I want you to fast, fast now, or stand. Wada. So what are the tenses? Madin, mudara, and amrun. Madin, مضارع وأمر three tense قال وينقسم إلى ثلاثة أقسام ماض ومضارع وأمر. So if you want to define past الماضي قال ما دل على حدث قبل زمان التكلم. The past الماضي is describing an action happened before the time of speaking. Now you're speaking, the action happened before you start to speak. That's madi. Al-mudara, qal, what al-mudara? Is the action happening at the time of the speaking or in the future or after it? نحو يكتب يصوم يسجد. الأمر, الأمر, the order, is an action required to happen at the time of speaking. Do. الحرف, الحرف, so the فعل here, إخواني, it has, just for you, one, ماض, two, مضارع, three, أمر, past, مضارع, present, future, أمر, imperative, or you can call it order or command. So the madin is the action happened before the time of speaking. The mudara is the action happening at the time of speaking or after. Al-amr is a request of action to be done just at the time of speaking. And this is when you put this in the Quran, then subhanAllah is going to be given a vast meaning and wider meaning into your mind. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, يَا أَيُّهَا الَّذِينَ آمَنُوا قُوْ أَنفُسَكُمْ وَأَهْلِيكُمْ. يَا أَيُّهَا الَّذِينَ آمَنُوا is the name, right? الَّذِينَ آمَنُوا is موصول with it. الَّذِينَ آمَنُوا أي يا أيها المؤمنون أو you who believe. نعم. قو أنفسكم. قو from وقى الوقاية. قو أمر. أمر. Shield yourself. ف when we say الأمر طلبوا فعل, request of action right at the time of speaking. So when you hear this from Allah, I said, now shield yourself and your family from the hellfire. Now. But people, when you read it, it's like something, it's like something is not happening. So قُوْ أَنفُسَكُمْ is an order of Allah to execute it right when you're reading the ayah. That's the amr. كُلُوْ This is amr. كُلُوْ مِمَّا رَزَقَكُمْ اللَّهُ. أَقِيمُوا الصَّلَاةَ amr. وَآتُوا الزَّكَاةَ أمر. يا الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله وكونوا مع الصادقين. كونوا اتقوا الله أمر. كونوا be with the truthful. So when you look at the Quran, you find the أمر, it's like one of the biggest part of the Quran, and you understand the meaning of the أمر, then you feel yourself obligated to do it right then, not to postpone it. That's why in postponing is like, what it mean postponing? You're not fulfilling the order. There's a question over there. So, I'll give you the break, the promised break, and we come back 15 minutes because we had many break for the prayer. 15 minutes. And then we pray around 25, right? The Isha is at 8:17, so we can pray Isha at 8:30. So we'll come back, inshallah, 8:05. That's good. Huh? Allah yahfadhik. بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم والصلاة والسلام على رسول الله وعلى آله وصحبه ومن والاه أما بعد. We just inshallah finish 5 minutes and then we start the تجويد class بإذن الله تعالى. In defining what is الحرف, so we define the meaning of الاسم and then الفعل and being associating when one of the tenses. And we saw the in the Arabic language the three type of tenses: ماضٍ ومضارع وأمرٌ. طيب ما هو الحرف؟ الحرف الحرف. In the language, الحرف means the edge. The edge. قال والحرف في اللغة الطرف ومنه حرف الحبل. The edge of the of the rope or the end of the rope. That's the harf. ومنهم من يعبد الله على حرف, on edge, very thin harf. طيب وفي اصطلاح النحويين, what mean harf in اصطلاح النحويين؟ كلمة دلت على معنى في غيرها ولم تقترن بزمان. It's a word that give a meaning to another. So the meaning is not in the word itself, the expression. But when you associate it, it helps to give a meaning to another word associated with. دلت على معنى في غيرها. So it's only have a meaning when you associate it in another word. For example, إلى to. What? To. If I add to the city, إلى المدينة, so إلى becomes as a meaning when I add to it the city. Okay? I say beneath, under. Ender, what to say? Ender the water. So you give me meaning. So the ender become has a meaning when you associate with it the word. So dallat ma'na fi ghayra. When you associate with another, that when it has a meaning. It give you, when you said the nahwiyin, a meaning, that complete meaning. Because say tahta ender, say ender what? Okay? So this is the meaning of harf. This is the meaning of the harf. And is not associated with time. Is not associated with time. So is not muqtarina bi time. So I said ender doesn't mean like I'm talking past, present, or future. No, ender is like a word composed from letters that its meaning, or it only had meaning when you associated with another word. That's the harf. Okay? So this is, we conclude the class today by the defining the harf, as we have mentioned, and the language and the speech in the Arabic language. We said يتكون الكلام من اسم وفعل وحرف, and الفعل associated with tense, which are ماض مضارع وأمر, والحرف is اسم قال كما قال ليس اسم ولكن لفظ الحرف كلمة دلت على معنى في غيرها ولم تقترن بزمان. So this is the if we which verse, this one is verse is number 6. Okay, so we have finished today verse number 6. والاسم والفعل ثم الحرف جملتها أجزاؤه فهو عنها غير منتقلي. The name, the verb, and then the harf. Those are the comprehensive, the three category which compose the whole speech of the Arabic language. أجزاؤه, these are the parts of it. فهو عنها غير منتقل, does not have any other category beside the category that we have mentioned. Next week, inshallah, we started with the name, the nouns, and define the name والمرفوع إلى آخره. So the next week will be getting in more details, and it will be making more, meaning to you, inshallah. Father. هانت become easy. Becomes إني هانت مسائله. هان الشيء أي سهل. سهل الشيء. هان سهل. يعني هو الكلمة has different meaning. It depends on its position. But here هان سهل. Becomes easy. هانت مسائله. And هانا usually comes expressing something is difficult. And when you do an action, becomes easy. So هانا comes by feeling like telling you, usually people they think is difficult. If you do this, it's going to be easy for you. هانت مسائله. يقول بعد الفرج كل شيء يهون. After the relief, everything becomes easy. Before, in time of difficulty, everything was hardship. طيب.